Curator Martin Boswell of the Duxford branch of the Imperial War Museum is an expert in the history of military camouflage.
This is a remarkable and unique object in the museum's collection, and these are extremely rare. This is part of an individual sniper's uniform. It's a robe that was donned over his what we call service dress. In this case, he's actually sewn some organic material as well as overpainted it, very much to his own design and taste. Well, this would complement any of the sniper's personal equipment, which he would have made up himself. These are absolutely unique items like this, and sniper's mittens and sniper's robes. Very much improvised, and you can see this is made of ordinary sacking. It has an aperture so that the man can see through this vision slit, and it has metal gauze sewn so that he can see out but you can't readily see him. And then finally, it's overpainted, very much in the method to this man's choosing for the area that he'd be operating in. These really would not survive, and it's nothing short of a miracle that 95 years later, this is still in our museum's collection. Well, this is another example of a hand-improvised sniper's robe of the sort used by the British Army in the First World War. And it comprises of a cotton loose-fitting robe, a button-over hood and mask with apertures to the mouth and to the eyes.
Snipers customized their camouflage for use in all terrains and weather.
A totally insulated jacket, overcoat that had the flexibility of being able to be reversible. So you could wear this out in the white, and if you changed terrain or if the ice and snow melted, you could wear the external camouflage. Sniping was a constant irritant, and still is, for any force that's involved in warfare. But certainly, these guys had the edge.